long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away, a beam of light left a blazing blue star. One of countless beams escaping the fiery surface every second, in every direction, into the black cold of space. This beam of light, traveling in a particular direction from the star, was joined by rays from surrounding stars. Together, they rushed through space at a tremendous speed. In another galaxy, on one planet circling about a medium-sized yellow star, semi-intelligent beings inhabited lush areas of a large continent. They were hunters, traveling in groups, bound by primitive social instincts. 32,000 years from its ultimate destination, the light passed among the outermost stars of another galaxy, of which the yellow star and its ice-bound planet were but small and insignificant members. Great clouds of interstellar gas and dust existed in this new galaxy. These clouds absorbed some of the light rays as they sped through and scattered others. When the light was 65,000 years from the end of its journey, the natives of the planet shivered in the bitter cold at the height of the Ice Age. Still, the light sped on, traveling at its original speed. During the remaining 2,000 years of travel for the light, the inhabitants of the planet continued to study the sky. However, in some places, scientific thought about the precise nature of what was seen in the heavens was dictated by religion. Gradually, the planet's people learned to see the night sky for what it really is. A science called astronomy developed as the study of the outer space around the planet. You, of course, are one of these natives. When you go outside at night and gaze up to the heavens, over here, in the direction of the constellation Andromeda, you will see the light that has traveled for more than 2 million years to reach our planet. The light emitted by the stars in the great Andromeda galaxy.